Rocket to Russia is the third studio album by the punk band Ramones. Never really cared for the Ramones. I'm gonna do something really unprofessional right now. Turn on the lights. There we go. Nice preparation. Yeah, so the third studio album by this band. I didn't really care for their debut album. I believe they had a really tight budget when they made that one. No surprise for me. Yeah, so they had some more money this time around, and it definitely worked because the production, although not very differently, it is improving. It has been improved. There we go. So it's a little bit longer, it's 31 minutes and 46 seconds, and I think the minimum time that you need to have on a record to really color the record is, I think, 30 minutes at least, or maybe 40, but that's of course debatable. And I believe even my favorite, like really short ass record is, I believe, under the 30 minute mark. Rain of Blood, no? Yeah. Rain in Blood is 28 minutes and 58 seconds, so I still love records that have, you know, sorry for that. And I still love records that have, you know, a runtime of below 30 minutes. So there we go. 31 minutes, like I said. Didn't really sound that different from the debut one. I do think that the songs are better, but not per se, you know, but not per se amazing, like some people would have thought. Requested by Steven Young, who really wanted me to check out Ramones for some reason. And yeah, you know, same thing as I thought. Not the worst band, not my favorite band, so that's really my relationship with this band. And after listening to this record, it hasn't really changed for me. And these are the two most acclaimed albums by them, so it's gonna go all downhill from here. We have Creeding Hall, which is kind of a half-assed opening track. 1 minute and 55 seconds, didn't really care for this track. It's just kind of generic, kind of bland, but still alright. Then we have Rockaway Beach, kind of the most funny Joey Ramone vocal line ever on here. Rockaway Beach, you know, he's going kind of like a frog right there. It's kind of stupid, it's kind of dumb. It's just kind of the worst of both worlds, but I still like the song. It's funny, it's catchy. It's kind of, you know, it's a dumb song, but it's enjoyable, and that's all that matters. Here Today, Gone Tomorrow is arguably the epic of the record, really. 2 minutes and 47 seconds. It's kind of a fast-driving song, you know, about being here today, going away tomorrow, which is kind of happening in my life right now, but, you know. not going to talk about that, but Here Today, Gone Tomorrow, you know, very relatable song for me, and it's also kind of a fast-driving song, so fun. Then we have Rocket Love, and this is kind of, you know, talking about the Rocket to Russia thing. They're talking about rockets here, talking about spaceships and shit like that, so it's another driving song. I don't care, exactly, move the fuck on. Sheena is a punk rocker, Sheena is a punk rocker, is the epic of the album, 2 minutes and 49 seconds. 20 hours ago, I wanna be today. Or no, this is actually another song. This is one that goes like, Sheena is punk rocker, Sheena is punk rocker. It is a pretty funny song. I do really enjoy the vocal performance on here. It's kinda like, you know, Rockaway Beach and Sheena is a punk rocker. Maybe this really offends you, you know, click off if you're like a diehard Ramones fan. If you're a Ramones fan in general, don't watch these videos because you're gonna get sad if you watch my videos. Sad in general, but you know, you get sad because I have a really negative opinion about the Ramones because they're samey as shit. So there's record right here. You know, Rockaway Beach and Sheena's a punk rocker kind of remind me of The Room. It's so bad that it's good. It kind of has that mentality for me. You know, it's funny. It's bad. I know those are bad tracks, but they're funny to me. They're fun songs. They're fun to listen to. They're fun to rock out to. Just put your brain to fucking zero and enjoy these tracks. Because that's essentially what I think about these tracks, you know, if you like dumbed down music, if you like, you know, simplistic ass music like the Ramones, then these tracks are perfect for you. And I still enjoy them, you know, I'm not saying I'm a retard, you know, you can't call me that, but if you put your brain to zero, if you just don't fucking care, then these tracks are perfectly fine, so there we go. Then we have We're a Happy Family, which is also another epical record, 2 minutes and 47 seconds. It's kind of, you know, kind of feel-good scrap, it's kind of, you know, like that. It's funny, it's quirky, it's kind of cheesy. Still like it, it still is an epical record, so there's that. Still a good song overall. Yeah, you know, still belongs into the classics, I think, so there we go. Then we have Teenage Lobotomy, which is just kind of like the version of, you know, punk. They're kind of rebelling on here, you know, Ramones isn't really a controversial band, I believe, but they are rebelling on this track, you know, they're saying, oh, lobotomy, this is not right, this is not the way how it's supposed to be. And yeah, they're like really, they're really having an outcry on this track. You can really hear that, you can really hear the angst on this track, you can really hear all of those fucking fake-ass Ramones fans screaming at them. So this is a good track overall, I did enjoy it, but can do without. Do You Wanna Dance is a Bobby Freeman cover. You know, I did enjoy it, it was alright, it was kind of, you know, quirky, it was kind of jazzy as well, so kind of jazz-punk fusion, it's kind of interesting. I Wanna Be Well is another track that, you know, they're talking about I Wanna Be Well, so there we go. This fucking album review is really half-ass right now, but I mean, the Ramones for me are an half-ass band, so why not do the same back, right? I Can't Give You Anything is kind of a quirky, quick little, if not all of their songs are, quick little song that is about, you know, can give you this, can give you that, you spoiled fucking brat. So there we go. Yeah, they're talking about spoiled people, I believe. Spoiled, yeah, people in general. Enjoyable track, enjoyable lyrics, relatable lyrics for me for sure. So there we go. And then we have Ramona, which is kind of the dumbest song on this record ever. Ramona, you know? Not Ramones, but Ramona. Yeah, I'm gonna leave it at that. Then we have Serving Bird, which is another classic on this album. This is another song on this album, which is like, you know, it's so bad that it's good. It's kind of like, you know, a part three of Rockaway Beach and Sheena's punk rocker. So of course I love it. I love it because it's kind of like room quality. It's horrible, but it's funny. It's a funny song, and that's all that matters. So I'm not saying this album is bad. Well, maybe I am, but I'm saying that this this album in particular is funny. This is a funny album. It's funny. It's quirky. It has charisma. It has balls. So I do like all those elements. The only problem is that it doesn't have any intelligence, which kind of reflects the romance. But there we go. You know, they can't attack me because they're all dead. So there's that. Serving Birds, really enjoyable track. You know, it's exactly the punk version of Serving Bird, the trash man, you know, and that's essentially what it is. I really love, you know, the vocals by Joey Ramone as well, when he has a fucking stroke towards the midway section, you know, when he goes like that. I do think that's really funny. It's really hilarious. So thank you, Steven, for requesting this album. It was really funny. And this, Why Is It Always This Way, is the final song of the album, another classic on this record because it's essentially another epic. Yeah, really, really intricate part, funny. Yeah, just really a punky, ferocious, punk fucking song. And what the fuck is that? Fucking Dutch music. Fucking gar. Oh my god. I believe my neighbors are playing that right now, but yeah, I'm gonna end this fucking album review because there's music. It's crap. Yeah, so this album is pretty good. Why Is It Always This Way? Kind of punky, kind of the same shit as always, but you know, kind of more emotionally driven, kind of more meaningful, but still kind of the same shit, but still much closer anyway. So, good album. It was better than the self-titled, but I wouldn't really call it, you know, a great record. It was still good. Still a good album. So I'm gonna give it a 7 out of 10. Pretty funny album. Let me know what you thought about it in the comments down below. Don't forget to follow me on Metalstorm, on Music, and on my other channel, Shadow Realms. The other thing, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this one, and I will see you guys in the next one. God bless. God bless. Safe, take care, and peace. Fuck no.